Hello.
Oh. Hi, John.
Guys, how are you?
Yeah. Sealed with a loving kiss is not really complete until we do this part two. Sealed with a loving kiss part two, which is the film we're about to make. We would like to show how the artisanal could influence the ready-to-wear and how it can inspire us and the industrialization of fashion. The accessories, the shoes, the bags, the jewelry, etc. Yeah. Et cetera. There's a bit of a twist.
Yeah.
I would hope so.
Inspiration. Yeah, because you have to have a little surprise.
Yes.
But after La Pache,
the
sweat becomes sweat. Singing in the rain.
Oh, I love that. But...
Nicholas, what are we going to do?
Yeah.
A nice way lead into our wet look.
I can't wait to see everyone moving and
getting wet.
Oh, yeah, you know, it's great.
We have asked Leon and Anton already
to take tango
lessons.
Oh, good.
Brilliant.
Really into it. Then, of course, like I asked Leon and Anton, they would do it, and the whole studio wants to go to tango classes.
When you walk, you
years ago, I went to Argentina, to Buenos Aires.
Yeah.
There was a town there called La Boca, very poor town. But the mayor had encouraged everyone to paint their houses in bright colors to attract tourism. So I ended up there, and of course I ended up there, and I had to see tango, but the real tango.
Yeah.
And we had a guide, and often on my research trips, I'd get through a few of them until we found the one that was really cool and knew, you know, that we were serious. And so anyway, it went on for a couple of days and they kept showing me these dancers on street corners or brasseries. And it was like, oh, this is just like veneers.
Yeah, totally.
I'm like, no, it's okay, we're cool, we can take it, you know. And what I discovered was that it's a very sought after dance. It's almost like a rave held in buildings, dilapidated buildings about to fall down. That's why they don't announce it. It's all word of mouth. So it's a surprise. Anyway, we got on that circuit and we became friends and they could see that we were very serious. And we were invited, no cameras, no sketchbooks, nothing. We weren't allowed to record anything. And in a way, I'm really glad because that memory has never left me. We were taken to what was like an abandoned building, dilapidated above a garage, and I remember the smells going up the stairs, and there was a roof that had just fallen through.
Yeah.
Wild cats just running up, the moonlight pouring into what looked like a rave club. I mean, it was like, so that was the first shock, if you like. Then the second shock was what I saw, and I just remember the gang that were with me, and I just held their hands and I went, this is the real thing, this is the real thing, this is the real thing. An 80-year-old man with silver-grey hair in a suit fitted to within an inch of his life, the shoes shiny, pointy, the hair slicked back, white, silver, this moonlight coming in. And as he began to dance, it was like a story was being told through his every movement, through the lines on his face, the creases worn into his clothes. You could sense the life this person had lived.
I've lived in the same place all my life. Some people call us backwards because we stay here as the seasons turn from fall to spring and back again. And they think our lives must be without movement or mystery. Back then, I was preparing to get married to the girl whose father repaired spectacles in the village. Her father and my father had made a pact when we were born that we would marry someday, and so far that seemed to be just the way things were going. We didn't know the thunder that would meet us that summer.
Mm-hmm. And then I thought it would be a really good time to actually explain what all these little numbers mean.
Yeah.
Some diehard fans know, some new ones that may be perplexed. And some of the numbers have been slightly, no, I wouldn't say redefined. Here we begin to call it iconics. It's actually part of the AVP line, which some might know better as a pre-call. Martin called it avant-première. What we do now, if there's a shape, a block, a fit, a style that has success, I transfer that block or shape in the hope that it could inspire brand loyalty. You know, Nick, you go to a certain place to buy your shirts because you like the fit. I'll go to the same place to buy my coat because I like the fit. Even if the designer at that place reinterprets it in different fabrics, a tweed, a print, it's the block that works for me. Do you know what I mean? There are certain places you go back. So we begin to call it iconics just to elevate.
Summer was so hot, I could see the heat waves rolling up from the road. And through that August haze came a strange arrival. Distance cousins to my fiancé, sent to live with them when their parents died, who would turn my world upside down.
Fast signature perfume from Maison Margiela. I had many memories. Some of them came from my research trips, and this one was actually a memory from Buenos Aires and this amazing smell of tuberose. The challenge was to decorticate the tuberose to its essence.
They were wild things. You could tell they couldn't wait to get out, but the life they planned was bigger than all of us. The men in the village fell for them, one after the other, and they were vicious and cruel in return.
Iconic lines consist of renewed classics that follow the codes of the house and our pyramidal approach to creativity, a proposal of a luxury, genderless wardrobe which pays special attention to quality and detail. You'll see something from Artisanal,
where
it's completely decorticated, almost a fishbone or a cage. Then underneath, you'll see the subtle use and reinterpretation of it. First picture is the tab on a trench when you peel it back. Here we explore different ways of producing the button, and often you'll see a little M in red stitching.
Right.
Very, very subtle to denote the difference in these lines. Right. And then the penultimate picture is almost like a decorticate to reveal a banker's pinstripe lining, and it's in a trench coat. Yeah. There's just a few little things that are kind of hidden, but once you're in the club, you know. Okay, the shoes, we can tear through these. Like we started to do in Artisanal. Just don't turn it into a ballad.
No, I think it's the thing.
We've done these quite elegant, pointed Mary Janes. These are a bit more sleazy, these shoes. Imagine him wearing them with his suit.
Amour, amour, quand tu nous tiens, dansons, castagne et tango, olé.
Princess Julia.
Yeah. These are cute.
They're really cool.
The shoes, some of them are in 18th century brocade that we found in Venice.
So is that quite a 50s shoe or a 40s shoe, John?
50s, I'd say. 50s with that skanky heel, you know?
Is that the name for it, the skanky heel?
Yes.
People in our village were poor, but we could dance. And the tango was our way of life.
Amour, amour, quand tu nous tiens, amour, amour, tu nous tiens bien, ton corps blotti contre le mien, dansons, castagne et tango, olé, ici la brise est parfumée, du goût léger, des orangers. De joie de vivre et de chanter, amour, castagne et tango, olé.
I had never spoken to them. Nails dug into my flesh as they said, you will be my partner. There was no question that I would do as I was asked. I was deaf.
Paris nous invite aux arbres le plus caressant. Prendre mes lèvres avec la rose de leur sang dans les soupirs et les frissons. L'amour mène le bal au rythme infernal du désir international. Yo te quiero, chérie, je t'aime. Kiss me, my love.
This was kind of like, I imagined them a bit like dancing tango dance marathon, that's it.
Yo estaba bien. An intense marathon proceeded.
Por un tiempo.
A fiery procession of couples twirling and flailing. The mundanity of our village life seemed miles away from the passionate war we fought on the dance floor. We danced for days as people withered and felt all around us.
Yo que pensé que te olvidé, pero es verdad, es la verdad.
They would not give up or let go. Their eyes pierced me, and I was drawn into terrifying blackness. Their feet bled into their shoes as they wheeled and stomped. The prize money was their ticket to freedom, and nothing would get in their way. Just as the last couple left on the floor seemed to have to renew its surge of energy, the twins stomped with all their might on the rival's foot, breaking it. They took their prize money and left, and I never saw them again. But it was too late, I was transfixed. The fragrance lingered all around, and I held onto those blood-stained shoes like a sacred relic. It wasn't until I heard that someone had killed them and dumped their bodies in the Matanza River that I couldn't bear to set a date for the wedding. I imagined limp bodies floating in that river, poisoned for centuries with arsenic and lead from the factories.
Replica, an exact copy or reproduction. Beyond the simple notion of a copy, replica suggests a sense of timelessness that is essential to the Maison Margiela philosophy. Alongside the house codes, the replica concept implies a gesture, the act of selection transformed into an art. Collected around the world, these pieces, which have caught the eye of the creative team, will be able to fully express their potential as they enter the Margiela wardrobe, the shape, fabric and details of each garment religiously copied to create a near-identical version of the original. Retroglare. Maison Margiela starts on sustainability. Retroglare is a label given to authentic vintage pieces handpicked by the design teams to be restored and reappropriated as limited edition garments or accessories. Breathing life back into charity shop finds, repurposing wicker bags, utilizing dead stock fabric and using offcuts of luxury leathers all speak to the mentality and ethics of today. Anti-waste, upcycling, make to amend. There is no longer a need to rely on old marketing and merchandising strategies. Instead, Retroglare can be used as inspiration for a new way of selling, tailor-made to local markets.
Retroglare has to go through really stringent tests. I'm just beginning to learn. It depends what they're dyed with, if there's lead in the dye. Yeah, sure. There's all that chemistry and scientific. It's quite amazing. Well,
what were they testing for, John?
Different dyes that maybe we can't wear on our skin today, whether they're based on lead or different chemicals that may have been used in the production of that cloth.
The twins never got where they were going to. But even still, with the date of my wedding looming, I clung to those shoes the way they clung to my heart. It was like time stopped that night. All the people in the village were so relieved when we finally set a date for the wedding. Our parents had been worried about what fate would bring down on me if I had broken the engagement. In the old ways, there were dire consequences for breaking a chain forget by the elders.
Generational thing. It was family. Yeah. That was obviously his granddaughter or whatever. Yes. And it's passed down. So what looked really kind of weird, was actually generations of family all together passing on this knowledge. Boys with boys, girls with girls, girls with boys, men. Amazing. Yes. Amazing. And it's kind of, I just thought, very inspiring. I mean, of course, as well, you'll see how some of the clothes have been interpreted in a genderless way, thanks to all the work we did with Nikki and Anton, where you may have noticed in the fittings, I kept cross-referencing. If it didn't look cool on a boy or a girl, it kind of dropped. So the result is those things that are genderless. I should add here, as the result of the pandemic, this time in the showroom, we will be selling the two together. So they'll be as they've been originally conceived. Mm-hmm. So you walk into a showroom and there'll be a beautiful collection there of genderless clothes. Of course, I think you're all aware of our quest to produce genderless clothes.
Hello, Mr. Galliano.
Hello, how are you?
I am Keisuke Watanabe from Maison Margiela Tokyo.
We have customers for long 20 years, and They sure will be very interested in a new port, such as Reticula. I would like to know if you have a specific vision or objective when you handpick the vintage pieces for Reticula.
Each time, it's a dialogue. It works both ways. I can go out, find the piece, and the dialogue begins, and then go out and further search for pieces once I've learned. So it's a really exciting project, and as I said earlier, it speaks the grammar of today. Haute couture is what Maison Margiela referred to as artisan. Co-ed is the ready-to-wear. For Margiela, the co-ed is an artistic industrialization of the artisanal.
So let's just tear through. So like the black ones, Nick, a reviewed version of the white ones, the celestial, but now they look kind of oily and
oily. Yeah.
They just look like that gentleman I described, like that's his favorite suit and he has worn it for the last 40 yeah. years. Sweat marks, all those things we love, the memory of his life.
Yeah.
They're there. About the old Brill cream and it's stained his collar, you know, the cuffs, that they've all got that slightly usé emotion, history. Fraction of a tango shirt, if you like, but on a crumpy coat.
Yeah,
it
is
canvas, I mean, like major tailoring. So here they start to take form and shape as tango dresses. No. The application, I'm sorry. The wet application.
I think I'm paranoid and complicated.
The way that the
material is
working.
It's three layers actually. It's a white base dress, a silver grey, and then a black tulle on top. When I saw what I saw, the age was irrelevant, the energy I saw there. So I can imagine more elderly members of the family as characters too. Yeah. And maybe that would be the kind of dress she would wear with her little raffia embroidered bag. You know, there was carry the money in the bag, don't they, all the cash. I think each, as I imagine the characters, they could become one of these ladies, or boys. Great little twin sets, you can see, you know, the in cashmere and cotton, it's all the kind, but kind of shrunk down, almost really? Like shrunk to fit, and you get in the bath and they fit you, that kind of vibe. These are all bits and pieces she's found and then crocheted together, so it's a bit of bits of old hat voilage, voilette, that she's kind of linked together. They're really beautiful. I know it's like a lace curtain from an old brass eye picture or a tablecloth from Buenos Aires. That's retro. Accessories. So, oh, look, Roe.
Wow.
And so the straps of the dress kind of
come into it.
The night before the wedding, I had a dream. I saw 11 stars shining all around her. The details of that mad tango all came back. The stabbing intensity of the movement, fabric chafing into flesh, the last notes of a dying bandoneon ringing in my ears. Something bad was going to happen.
Bye.
That's where I'm going for our little tango dancers.
That's pretty.
Yeah, really pretty. So they will be.
They look really
all over. We've saved them, and we're bringing them back to life. And so this is just a little collection.
The day of the wedding, my bride was beautiful, and she looked at me with the kind of love I knew was forever. Suddenly, I felt I was literally carrying someone on my back, like they were on me and in me, like I was a pedestal holding someone else up. I could smell them all around me. It was suffocating. I was becoming disoriented and faint. As I stood immobile, 10 men from the village surrounded me, like the 10 fingers of God, all waging at me in admonition, armed with a strange prayer box. But I was already gone. Just as I slipped from consciousness, it started to rain. They had to come to me on my wedding day, desperate, to stop me from moving on when they couldn't, to cling to that one day when they were a champion, another corpse in a poisoned river. Everyone knew what was happening. It was a superstitious village. My humid, heavy breath seeped into this old suit that night. Desperation, confusion, and elation settling into every crease. And now, a living memory that will continue to breathe on its own long after I'm gone. Maybe it will pick up and wander farther than I ever did.
And I just thought they were one-off pieces. They come with so much history.
Amour, amour, quand tu nous tiens, amour, Amour, tu nous tiens bien, ton corps blotti contre le mien, dansons castagne et tango, olé, ici la brise est parfumée du goût léger des orangers, de joie de vivre et de chanter, amour castagne et tango, olé. Paris nous invite aux arbres le plus caressant. Viens prendre mes lèvres avec la rose de leur sang dans les soupirs et les frissons. L'amour mène le bal au rythme infernal de désir international. Yo te quiero, chérie, je t'aime. Et dis-tu bien, ne me dis rien, ne pense à rien, laisse mon cœur avec le tien, amour et castagne et tango, olé. Paris nous invite aux arbres le plus caressant. Prendre mes lèvres avec la rose de leur sang dans les soupirs et les frissons. L'amour mène le bal au rythme infernal du désir international. Yo te quiero, chérie, je t'aime. Kiss me, my love. Quel est ton nom et dis-tu bien? Ne me dis rien. Ne pense à rien, laisse mon cœur avec le tien, amour et castagne et tango, olé. Quand le jour viendra frapper aux portes de la nuit, il disparaîtra sans doute à jamais de ma vie, mais pour garder toujours à moi la chaleur de ton corps, avant ton adieu, embrassons-nous plus fort encore. Yo te quiero, chérie, je t'aime. Que j'ai mis my love. Amour, amour, tu m'appartiens. Ton corps blotti contre le mien. Dansons tous deux jusqu'au matin. Amour, castagne et tango. Oh.